Ah, London, my beloved capital city, bustling with so much art, so much beauty, so much history, an iconic place, renowned the world over. So it may come as a little bit of a shock to you that 1,500 acid attacks have been recorded in London since 2011. Oh, that multiculturalism, that multicultural goodness, it has worked out so very well. Acid attacks in Britain's capital are soaring to new heights, new data reveals. A Freedom of Information request submitted by the Mirror shows that between 2011 and 2016, London had nearly 1,500 cases of the devastating crime, which burns the skin and leaves victims cowering from their injuries. In the long term, the scale of the injuries are so scarring that victims can often suffer serious psychological damage as a result of the attacks. Last year alone, there were 431 such acid attacks, a rise of 170 cases from the previous year. The figures match a general UK trend, in which the crime rate for such attacks has risen by 50% since 2005. And here you see all the London boroughs with the most incidents of acid attacks. Newham at the top, Barking and Dagenham at second, and Tower Hamlets 84, and then it goes down the list there. Just for time's sake, we're going to focus on the top three boroughs for this video. But before we get into that, just keep this in mind. The difficulty and emotional trauma in reporting acid attacks can also mean that the figures are severely underinflated. Newham, in East London, had the highest instances of acid attacks with 398 in the last 6 years. Let's take a closer look at Newham, shall we? Newham has the youngest overall population and one of the lowest white British populations in the country, according to the 2011 census. The borough has the second highest percentage of Muslims in Britain, after the London borough of Tower Hamlets at 32%. And strangely enough, I'm not saying they're connected here, I'm not saying anything. I'm not making any ridiculous claims here, guys, but Tower Hamlets is third on this list. Huh. I'm sure that's not related. Let's move on. Newham has the lowest percentage of white British residents in all of London's boroughs. The white British proportion of the population fell from 38.8% in 2001 to 16.7% in 2011. So essentially, the white British population in Newham has been culled since 2001. I wonder who replaced them. People of white British ancestry nevertheless remain the largest single ethnic group in the borough. The largest non-white British ethnic groups are Indian, African, Bangladeshi, and Pakistani. The ethnic group to increase the most in number since 1991 is the Bangladeshi community. So Newham has the highest rate of acid attacks in London, and also the fastest growing Bangladeshi community. Bangladeshis, what are they renowned for again? Oh, look at this. Since the 1990s, Bangladesh has been reporting the highest number of acid attacks and the highest incident rates for women in the world. Damn, so Bangladesh has the highest acid attack rates in the world. I wonder why that is. Let's read on. Islam is the largest religion in Bangladesh, adhered to by about 86.6% of the population. The country is home to the most Bengali Muslims, the second largest ethnic group in the Muslim world. Bangladesh has the fourth largest Muslim population in the world and is the third largest Muslim majority country after Indonesia and Pakistan. So Bangladesh reports the most acid attacks in the world. It's also the third largest Muslim majority country in the world. I'm sure those things are completely unrelated. Let's move down the list again though. Let's go to Barking and Dagenham, which is second on the list. At the time of the 2011 census, 49.5% of the borough's community identified themselves as white British. Barking and Dagenham has been strongly affected by immigration, with the white British population having dropped 30.6% from 2001 to 2011, the second largest decrease in the country behind neighbouring Newham. The population of non-UK born residents increasing by 205%. The largest minority communities were of black and Asian heritage. Asian heritage, oh fuck. Barking and Dagenham was also the place, by the way, just as a side note, that when returning British troops from Afghanistan marched through the streets, they were met by abuse from its local Muslim population, who chanted, amongst many other things, UK troops, go to hell. Yep, everything's looking rosy in Dagenham. Next, let's look at Tower Hamlets. Tower Hamlets has a population of 272,890, which includes one of the highest ethnic minority populations in the country and has an established British Bangladeshi business and residential community. Tower Hamlets has one of the smallest indigenous populations of the boroughs in Britain. No ethnic group forms a majority of the population. A plurality of residents are of white ethnicity, 45%, of which 31% are white British. Asians form 41% of the population, of which 32% are Bangladeshi, which is the largest ethnic minority in the borough. I am shocked, guys. Let's read on. Tower Hamlets has the highest proportion of Muslims in England. There are more than 40 mosques and Islamic centres in Tower Hamlets. What is this information saying, guys? Because in my head, I'm trying desperately, just so desperately, to justify multiculturalism. Because, as we all know, diversity is our strength. If I'm not mistaken here, then there seems to be a correlation between Bangladeshi immigrants and acid attacks on the rise in London. Bangladesh reports the highest number of acid attacks in the world. Bangladesh is also 86% Muslim, and the third largest Muslim majority country. All three of these boroughs we've looked at have a high proportion of Muslim immigrants, most of which seem to be Bangladeshi. Oh, this can't be true though. I was always told that multiculturalism was a positive thing, that it was something we should all strive towards, that the West needed multiculturalism, that we couldn't get by on our own cultures, we needed to import other ones. I'm just confused as to why barbaric cultural practices are being brought over here too. I thought all cultures were equally good. Yeah, fuck that. We all know what's going on here. Multiculturalism is a mess. It's failed. It doesn't work. This is just more proof of it. The rate of acid attacks in London, Britain's capital city, is soaring. And strangely enough, they seem to be most prominent in boroughs with large Muslim Bangladeshi communities. I'm sure these things have nothing in common. Very interesting indeed. Thank you once again everyone for watching. I may make this into a series called Multiculturalism Fails, because there's plenty of material for it, believe me. Please share this video around. I feel it's a very important subject that needs to be addressed. I'm prepared to be labelled as a racist and Islamophobe and whatever bullshit buzzwords they want to throw at me. But you can't deny the correlation between these two things. Okay guys, until next time.